Hi y'all, it's Brian from iSpring, and this time we're going to talk about the great new assignments feature in iSpring Learn. After a learner submits an assignment, the instructor can grade it. Let's see how this works. First, go to the Contents section, and then you can add an assignment here from the Add Course dropdown. Give it a title and description, and set a passing score in percent. Here on the Details page, you can see all the information here, and attach extra materials with this button. Just find the files, and they will be attached to the assignment. There's a limit of 10 documents per assignment. You wouldn't want to overload a single assignment anyway, now would you? When you're done on this page, click Save to lock it all in. And over here on the Settings tab, you can issue a certificate and notify one or more admins when the assignment is complete. The Availability tab has a link to the assignment, plus e-commerce settings and viewing restrictions to set time and attempt limits. You can use this section to specify a due date for the assignment. To assign this item to learners who are already registered in your LMS, just go to the Permissions tab. Click Change and put in the details here. Now click Save. Okay, so now I've logged out of the admin account and here I am in the student account. And here's my assignment on the ToDo page. When I open it up, I can see the description and the attached file, and down here I can write my answer. Not only that, students can attach their own file as an answer. As you can imagine, the possibilities here are limitless. You can attach a document for proofreading, you can assign a short story to be analyzed, and much more. I'll just put in a generic answer and post it to the assignment. Now, the status of the assignment is pending my instructor's approval. Back here in the admin account, you can see a notification on the dashboard that there are assignments to check. What I've done here is given a right answer and a wrong answer so I can show you pass and fail scenarios. Let's evaluate this first answer. On this page, you can see the learner's answer, and you can award it a score. Anything lower than the score you set will mean the assignment is declined, and anything higher will mean it's accepted. You can also add comments or questions, and attach more files here. Now I'll just go back here and decline this other answer real quick. And back here in the user portal, the assignment has now been moved to the completed section. And as you can see, it's been accepted. Let's see how a failed assignment looks. If you haven't limited the attempts to one, it will still be here in the to-do section, and here on the course info page, the user has another chance to answer it. The timeline of answers and approvals will be listed down here at the bottom. Finally, back here in the admin portal, let's go to the reports section and check out the brand new assignment results report. Select one or more assignments from the list, and choose which learners to include here in the report settings. I'm going to check Show the Report below so we can see it right here, and run it. It may take a little while to generate the report, so sit tight. In the report, you'll see a complete breakdown. It shows the number of assignments pending approval, not started by the user, declined by an instructor, and approved by an instructor. Down in this list, you'll also see timestamps, usernames, status, and number of attempts. Thanks for watching. I guess this is a sign you know how to assign assignments to assignees now. Did you like this video? Give it a like and subscribe to the iSpring YouTube channel for more updates.